You're watching General Counsel Studio, and I'm your host, Andrew Zezas. In the studio with us today is Ms. Maria Chiclana, Senior Vice President, General Counsel, and Corporate Secretary of American Standard. Ms. Chiclana received her JD from Harvard Law in 1987 and a BA from Barnard College, Columbia University in 1984, having graduated magna cum laude. Ms. Chiclana is a senior executive business leader and general counsel with over 25 years of experience. She's been with American Standard since November 2007 and oversees environmental health and safety across all facilities, risk management, and has been a human resources business leader at the company. Ms. Chiclana began her career as in-house counsel at Unilever in 1992. And held positions there in licensing, consumer and public affairs, and corporate communications. Interestingly enough, Ms. Chiclana was a licensed nurse in the state of New York. American Standard was recently acquired by Lixil, a $15 billion Japanese building products company. American Standard is a leading manufacturer of a wide range of high-quality kitchen and bath products for residential and commercial customers. The company employs more than 5,000 people and markets products under the brand names of American Standard, Jado, Porsche, Safety Tubs, Crane Plumbing, Elger, Fiat, and Decorative Panels International. Today, Ms. Chiclana is here to talk to us about raising the General Counsel standard. Maria, it's so nice to have you here in General Counsel Studio. Thank you.
It's a pleasure to be here, Andy.
Maria, we're talking about raising the standard. In the context of a general counsel. So, as a foundational question, share with me your views of what makes truly a great general counsel.
A great general counsel has to have due expertise in subject matter, legal topics, and also in business. In legal topics such as complex litigation, contracts, labor relations, IP, antitrust, and in business, you have to be a skilled negotiator and a good business person. I believe also a great general counsel should have great communication skills with a consultative edge because it's about giving guidance. It's about persuading people to see the reasons why they have to comply with certain aspects of the law, but also realize that in compliance, it can actually give you a business edge. I believe also that a great general counsel is a critical problem solver, and you get there by first synthesizing the information that you receive internally, by understanding what the business people are trying to achieve, and by understanding the external environment, the regulatory environment, the consumer and marketplace competitive environment, and synthesizing that information, applying it to the problem to solve it and create the solution for going forward. And lastly, I would say that a great general counsel is always intellectually curious and always has a collaborative spirit because there's a power with working with the team, and if you can leverage that power, the sum is always greater than the parts.
Wow, so the role of a general counsel is incredibly diverse.
Yes.
And not just about the law, and I know we've talked about this before. Share with me your views about those components, or I should say areas of expertise outside the law that you believe a great general counsel should be conversant in.
A great general counsel should absolutely be conversant in the business area and know the business dynamics in terms of how to create a value creation plan, how to execute on a value creation plan. You have to know the business drivers, such as what are the growth drivers, what are the profit drivers, what are the productivity drivers, because it's all about executing the strategy and delivering commitments and making the financial results and accelerating the growth.
Wow, so it's no longer about just contracts and lawsuits.
No, it's about strategy.
Yeah, sure sounds like it. So let's talk about the expertise that most general counsels need when they're looking outside the company. So you've described to me that a great general counsel is someone who understands a lot about a lot. Mm-hmm. Well, what expertise do they go outside for?
I would say that general counsels go outside law firms for complex mergers and acquisitions. I believe in today's economic environment, the deals are very complex. There's usually a target, and you're targeting that company for IP or for market growth or for certain channels or customer penetration, and the deals are very complex. They involve a variety of legal topics. They're heavily regulated by regulators in the antitrust field, in the environment field, and it's very important to have a very good legal team to support the different areas of the M&A deal. In addition, I would say for complex litigations, it's impossible to single-handedly do a complex litigation. It's just involves a great liability for the company, and it's good to have an outside law firm to provide the privilege protection and to help you execute the litigation strategy. I will also say if you're entering into new markets, it's always important to know the local law. You can think globally, but you always have to act locally, and it's important to know the rules of that particular region. And I would say that it's always the business is always well guided if you can go to outside counsel in that region and learn the business landscape, learn the cultural landscape, and learn the legal landscape. And outside law firms are particularly helpful if there's ever an area of any kind of criminality allegation, whether it's Federal Corrupt Practices Act or any allegation concerning personal liability, and in that sense, it's always good to bring in an outside law firm that can help you in that area, because as a general counsel, you're more versed in commercial law and not in criminal law.
So a good outside law firm becomes critical to the mission of the general counsel.
Absolutely, a good business partner.
Yeah, I can appreciate that. So let's talk about internal view of the general counsel. What are the most effective steps that a general counsel can take to forge deeper internal relationships and I guess I'd say more diverse partnerships within the company?
To forge deeper relationships and diverse partnerships, you first have to start off with a platform of credibility. I mean, people have to know that you have that expertise and that you're guiding them in the right direction. And it involves a collaboration and the ability to mentor people, but also to be mentored, because everyone can learn. And with the collaborative spirit, you realize that the team, the power of the team, can execute the strategy much faster and more on point. And I think if people understand then the different channels and the different functions, understand that you're trying to achieve the same business results and work as one company, one fully integrated company, that trust relationship begins. And there are no I gotcha moments. It's if there is a failure, you learn from it. You learn how to make it better the next time around. You raise the standard. But it's about really taking responsibility and accountability as a team.
And you said no I gotcha moments. So much less internal competition is what you're talking about.
Correct. It's all about collaboration and realizing that we all want to achieve the same strategy. It's one strategy, it's one company.
That makes a lot of sense. So as it relates to departmental relationships, which departments in most enterprises should be most closely aligned with the legal team or with the general counsel?
Sure. I find that there's a natural alignment with the finance group, because the finance group is always looking at sharing the responsibility of corporate governance and reporting on liabilities and making sure that the business is protected from a reserve and accrual standpoint.
Certain risks, sure.
Risk management is another group that is closely aligned with the general counsel office, because it's about protecting the assets of the company and also with product liability issues that fall within risk management. And also the innovation group, there's a lot of intellectual property. Those are the crown jewels of the business to protect. And the legal group would work very closely with making sure that the IP that's developed and innovated is protected. But at American Standard, Andy, I'll tell you that I find that all the departments are closely aligned with the legal group.
Really?
Yes. It is an integrated company, and when you think about it, it really makes a lot of business and common sense, because when you look at a company, it is one integrated company. Just think about all the different functions and how the process works. It's a dynamic where the human resource group, they hire the right people for the right jobs, procurement buys the materials, marketing creates the demand, manufacturing makes the product, quality checks it, distribution gets it out the door, the channels sell it into the markets, customer care makes sure the consumer is happy, legal makes sure there are no roadblocks along the entire process, and finance collects the money at the end of the day and reports on it.
Truly is an integrated company.
Yes.
Okay, so let's continue along those lines, integration, and it sure sounds to me like you're making the case that great general counsel is as much a great business person as a legal mind. So let's stay with that. How can a great general counsel be most effective in driving sales and revenue?
A great general counsel is most effective in that area by being a real strategic source of support to the business groups in achieving the sales, in achieving the revenue. It starts out in many number of ways. You can accelerate growth through mergers and acquisitions. Mm-hmm. So as a merger and acquisition partner, it's about realizing which is the right target for the business, where are the synergies, how can your growth be accelerated, in which markets can you be global, can you be local, and which customers, and what is the IP. There's also ways to grow through licensing, inbound and outbound. You can license technology that goes into your products, and you can also license your brand or your own technology to other groups in your neighbor categories. And also there's organic growth in terms of helping the business functions achieve greater gross margins by perfecting the relationship with customers, making sure the contracts are set, what are the rebates, what are the return policies, what are your costs in terms of suppliers, how you buy your materials, it's all contractual, your exclusivity periods to give you that speed to market edge, and distribution agreements. So it's all about helping the business achieve its goals. And the sales and revenue will come if you understand all the drivers, again, the profit driver, sure, the growth drivers, the productivity drivers. There are many ways to run your facilities. You wanna run them full. You wanna decide whether you're gonna make versus source in other countries. Mm. And it's all about optimization of the resources that you have.
So are you telling me that the general counsel is actually a customer care executive as well, in some respects?
Absolutely. The consumer always has to be in the forefront of your mind. I mean, it's basically how you survive in today's economy. You have to add value, and the customer is very important. We have customers and we have consumers. At American Standard, our customers are Home Depot, Lowe's, Menards, and then the consumers, everyone we touch in terms of the living space, because we have bath and kitchen products that serve every household in around the world. So it's a very exciting place, and it's nice wearing all these hats because you really see how it's all important. And I would say in-house counsel has the wrong nomenclature, because it's not just being in a business, it's working on the business.
Interesting. So let's stay with the same topic. General counsel, instead of driving sales and revenue, how can a general counsel be most effective in mitigating risk?
It starts with first appreciating and understanding the risk of the past, because sometimes events do repeat themselves. So you have to have an idea of what has been the historical experience for the company, and then knowing the emerging issues that are coming your way, coming the business way, through the regulatory environment, through the court environment, and knowing what are the risks that may come, and protecting against those future risks by always being prepared. You gotta have crisis plans in place. You have to implement scenarios and just be prepared for them. You have to communicate that to the business so that they know how to be prepared in case a crisis were to hit. I would say have a good insurance program in place to protect you in case there is risk. A good replacement cost program would be very ideal. But also in terms of basics, making sure your contracts are clear, that they protect you, they have the proper indemnities, and just making sure that your relationships are good, that you know how to negotiate, and that if there's ever any liability, you know what the settlement or the resolution levers are in terms of mitigating that liability.
All right, so that makes sense. Now, you've talked about how the general counsel is incorporated in some respects into the human resource function, but let me try to throw you a curveball. Talk to me about how the general counsel can be effective in terms of maintaining corporate culture.
Well, I believe that the values and the integrity and the transparency all really begin in the office of the general counsel. We do create a code of ethics, the way we would want the house to work. And we have to promote that, and we have to lead by example. So I believe we're a big promoter of company culture when it comes to transparency and integrity and values. And we work with people in always respecting people, trying to be fair with people, making sure there's no discrimination within the organization. But at the same time, just constantly reminding the business that when you act with integrity is the best way to act. And employee engagement is something that every group, including the Office of the General Counsel, can do, because it's about mentoring people, developing people, communicating the strategy is always very key. Many employees sometimes will express dissatisfaction if they don't feel they're an integral part, and it's about communicating the strategy and let them know that their part does matter and how we execute the strategy. And once you have that employee engagement and commitment, it can really lead to high performance.
Maria, can general counsels become catalysts for internal innovation, and can they drive change within an enterprise?
Oh, absolutely. In my office, for example, I work very closely with the engineering and innovation teams in developing new technology that is protected through patents and through trademarks and copyrights for the advertising programs that we set forth. And it's about working with them in terms of they'll come up with the idea, and then you have to do a competitive review to make sure that the idea isn't already out there, it's really a true idea. And sometimes you have to do design around discussions. And sometimes in trying to protect the idea, you actually can lend improvements as you discuss each claim and each part of the idea.
Coming out of the law department.
Wow. And also, it's good to insert some process where you have a stage gate review, and we instill that at American Standards so that the entire team gets together and can provide input to the innovation process. We also like to encourage, including the legal department likes to encourage, for external awareness, because you just can't invent within your own building and not have that outside perspective in terms of what do consumers want, what are the trends, what are the marketplace trends, and what's happening around the world. There's so much going on, and it's always good to learn from suppliers, business partners, consumers, and so forth.
Wow. Maria, you've shared a lot of great ideas with us today in General Counsel Studio. I truly appreciate your coming by to see us and giving of your insights. I hope you'll come back and see us again sometime.
I would love to. Thank you.
It's been a pleasure.
Pleasure.
This is Andrew Zezas, your host at General Counsel Studio, with Maria Chiclana of American Standard, saying thank you very much for watching. We'll see you again.